Hi, I'm Dr. Wordperson, and today we're going to talk about the International Phonetic Alphabet and vowels. Basically, linguists use this, the IPA, in order to transcribe all the sounds in the world's languages consistently. I'm going to teach you what all the squiggly little symbols mean and how to pronounce them with your mouth. So one of the really handy things about the IPA vowel chart is that it actually organizes the symbols according to the different parameters we use to pronounce different vowels. So notice that this chart has three dimensions: up, down, left, right on the chart, and left, right within each pair of vowels. Let's go through each dimension in turn. Two dimensions on the chart, up, down, and left, right, pertain to the position of your tongue and your mouth when you are producing that vowel. Up, down relates to how high or low your tongue is in your mouth, or in other words, how open or closed your mouth is when you are producing that vowel. So, for instance, the sound E is a high vowel. It is pronounced with your tongue very high in your mouth or with your mouth very nearly closed. E. Give it a try. I left a vowel off the chart. I'm gonna go fix this right quick. This vowel, which I just drew on the chart, is a low vowel. You pronounce it relatively low in your mouth or with your mouth relatively wide open. Next, right, left. You notice that when you produce vowels, you kind of bunch up your tongue in one particular part of your mouth, like ooh, you're kind of bunching it up in the back, and e, you're kind of bunching it up pretty far forward. So that is called frontness or backness. E is a front vowel. Your tongue is bunched up pretty far forward in your mouth. E, oo is a back vowel. Your tongue is bunched up pretty far back in your mouth. Oo. Now let's look at the third dimension, first or second in a pair. This has to do with lip rounding, basically what you're doing with your lips while you're pronouncing the vowel. My native dialect of English does not have contrastive lip rounding in vowels, so we're just going to go with two separate vowels for illustration. So notice E again, and how when you pronounce it, your lips are just kind of relaxed or whatever. E. And when you pronounce OO, your lips are scrunched up in kind of a kissing shape. OO. That lip scrunching is called lip rounding. When you have a pair of vowels, the first in the pair does not have lip rounding, while the second in the pair does. So for instance, with these, we have e and ö. Or for another example, we have e and ü. Or for another example, we have u and ö. So that is how the chart works. High, low, back, front, rounded, unrounded. Also, it is super handy if there is some vowel in a phonetic transcription you're looking at and you don't already know how to pronounce it. You can look at what vowels it's similar to and then just make the necessary adjustments to how you're pronouncing things to make that vowel sound come out of your mouth. So let's look at this upside down A right here. My dialect of English does not have that vowel, but it does have this other vowel sitting right there next to it, ah. Since upside down A is the second in a pair with A I already know how to pronounce, I can just pronounce A I already know how to pronounce with lip rounding. Aw. Woohoo! I pronounced a new vowel. Or take this one, this other little A. In my dialect of English, this only gets used in diphthongs, but if I want to try to pronounce it on its own, I can say like, oh, I already know how to pronounce ah, so this is a bit lower than that, so ah. Also, I want to point out that there is a very handy clickable IPA chart online where you can click on any one of the symbols and it will play that sound for you. Super helpful. Now, what about all the other properties of vowels like creaky voice and nasalization and length and all that other stuff? Well, we have diacritics for those. Check out the chart. So there you have it, the International Phonetic Association's handy-dandy system for representing every vowel sound in human language. Now go forth and harness its power for your own ends, and don't forget to make sounds with your mouth. All right, that was the show. Thanks for watching. Please be sure to check out the doobly-doo, because I have put links to the IPA chart and the handy-dandy talking clickable IPA chart down there. Like and subscribe, and watch some more of my videos, because they are fun and you will enjoy it. I just realized I forgot to draw in three more vowels. I am the worst. I'm not reshooting that whole thing. I'm sorry. The same principles hold, I promise.